It was in 1988 that I first met Buddhadas in Kerala, in his hotel room. Because Buddhadas was in Kerala, Trivandrum, to officiate as the jury chairman of the Kerala State Awards. And I know after the announcement of the award, he had called me through a friend, and I went and met him in the hotel. He had seen two of my films then, in that year, which was in competition, Oreduval Pakshigal and Piravi. As soon as I entered his room, he warmly welcomed me and said that I have seen your two films and I liked it, and why won't you work with me for my next film? So I was very happy that I have known Buddhadas' films and seen one or two of his films, and I very felt very happy to be able to work with him. So in fact, we discussed even the remuneration part and the dates of the next film, and I have agreed to all that. Meanwhile, Buddhadas was also in discussion with Venu, and eventually Venu started working with him. And he, Venu, as all of you know, he has done four or five of Buddhadas' films. And later at one point, Buddhadas called me again and said, "Sunny, now it is time you come and work with me." I said, "Yes." And that's how we started working in the Ami Yasin or Amar Madhubala. So when I think of the professional working relationship with Buddhadas as a director and myself as a cinematographer, the very first thing which comes to my mind is that I was very lucky to work with such a great filmmaker. When I say that this is from my heart, and because Buddhadas was one of the directors who could challenge me to bring out my best. He encourages you to do something which you haven't attempted earlier, and be not courageous probably to try out. But Buddhadas gives you that courage, and this was my experience that in all through my professional work, and when I when I have a director who has a correct knowledge of cinematography, it becomes much easier to work with that director. Buddhadas was such a director. He knew about cinematography. He himself did cinematography for many of his documentaries. So he was very well aware of the limitations and the possibilities of cinematography. I don't have to talk much about the the poetic essence of his cinema, because many of the film scholars have in detail talked about those things and studied those aspects, and it is all there. But I know myself that the poetic sentiment in him, the poetic heart he had, has reflected in his visualization and his way of making the cinema, presenting it to the audience. Yes, he was a poet, and his approach to life was also like that, and that reflects in his films. As all of you know, time and space are the two basic elements of cinema. And Buddhadas was an expert, of handling time and space in cinema like nobody else in India. Especially the way he handles space in his films, I have not seen in many other directors. In fact, I have learned a lot of things from Buddhadas in terms of how to handle the space in front of you. He is not, afraid of handling space in the sense that, otherwise, usually one will be scared of, rearranging space or even, do some alteration to it from one shot to another. It will be, very tricky. But with Buddhadas, since he understands the whole grammar, he can easily change all those things to suit the emotional content of the scene. He was not afraid of anything like continuity or anything like that. His primary concern was the emotion in the scene, and that he could handle very well. And the challenges he brings out are for a cinematographer is very good because usually you don't get that kind of challenges. When we started shooting in Ami Yasin or Amar Madhubala, the first thing he told me was, "Sunny, my working style is not like other directors. I don't. He has a script, but he doesn't prepare a shooting script like shot division and things like that." He told me that I will come to the set with the actors and you. I will try out the scene, and from that rehearsal, I will finally decide the way which I want to take the shot. I said it is fine. So that itself was quite an interesting thing because there is no preconceived idea of how to take that shot. So that made his films unique, and he was ready to spend that time to explore the scene and kind of arrive at a unique way of presenting the scene. So this also allows a cinematographer to think out of the box, and he is known for his long takes, and when I was working with him once, I remember we did place a 100-foot trolley, and that too, which will be, usually it will be a straight trolley or then circular trolley or some combination of it in a small way. But in that 100-foot trolley, we had two characters walking towards the camera in a corridor of a school veranda, and then the camera will slowly move out of the front-facing characters and come out of the veranda, and then for some time it will track parallelly with them. Then again go into the corridor, face them frontally, and then again come back into the outside, and it was a very complex shot. Even to level the track, at that length is a Herculean task. But Dada was ready to do all that and wait for things to get done properly, And once in an interview, Dada said that about my work, he said, every shot he takes will be a perfect one. So that is a great compliment, and it gives you a whole lot of confidence in one's work. Another unique thing I noticed in Dada, apart from other directors I worked that, he most of the time he probably works with one lens within a scene. So usually you changes the focal length of lenses from wide angle to closer shots. But Dada will take, suppose you start with a mid shot using 35 mm lens, and Dada will continue with that focal length. He will use only, whether I come and take a closer shot or a wider shot, he will use the same 35 mm lens to take the scene. Because his idea was correct, because if you change the focal length, within the given lighting condition, the depth of field will also change. So he didn't want that to happen. So in that sense, it was a kind of a very interesting thing to work with that one lens, within a scene. So like that, many things I have learned from Buddhada, new things, like even the simple Buddhada's device, using a trolley which will track parallelly and then move, on a 90-degree angle, using double trolleys, double tracks, one above the other. So all these kind of things, innovations he could do with the minimalist facilities available with him. All that points to the idea of an inquiring mind, which will try to use the whatever is available around him to achieve a new vision. When I think of his films, the ones which I worked, Ami Yasinor, Amar Madhubala, Wo, Janala, and the full-length documentary film on Calcutta University. When we talk about the lyricism and poetry in his films, we sometimes forget that his films were also socially committed, and he was talking most of the time people who are oppressed and not considered to be worthy of living, and the underdogs, of the society. In its thematic essence, his films were very contemporary, and it reflects our daily living situation around us. So I would say that he was very concerned about the environment which we are living, the social environment, and wanted to kind of see a new world. A real artist will always want to see the world changed, because the artist always attempt a creative endeavor when he or she thinks that whatever is happening right now is not up to the benefit of all. That is the disturbance from which all artists try to say something which probably will change that situation. So Buddhadas' films were also like that, which would attempt to show us a certain different way of living, and Buddhadas films will also show us some the other kind of life possible, and it in fact helps us to look at others and life in general in a new way. So that is the fundamental role of any artistic creation. In that sense, Buddhadas films have achieved that, and it directly talks with the audience with a lot of compassion and sincerity. In this occasion of remembering Buddhada and his great contribution to Indian cinema, it is a personal loss to me, and also it is a great loss to the Indian cinema, and I fondly, with a lot of love, remember Buddhada, and it will be my endeavor also to be, if ever I could achieve such kind of quality in my own work, it will be my tribute to Buddhada.